midday yesterday, the biggest business organization in the state of Wisconsin, Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, put out a poll that they have done recently. This is on the political races here in Wisconsin, as well as to collect consumer views on certain things. Joining me to talk about it is Scott Manley, the president of WMC. Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good morning, Jay. Doing very well.
Good to have you on the show again. So this was a poll of about 600 likely Wisconsin voters, people who say they intend to vote, conducted over 3 days in early July. So this is after Biden's bad debate performance, but before the Trump assassination attempt. What did you find when it came to the presidential race? I found this a little surprising.
Well, it was a little bit surprising to us too, Jay. What we found is that President Trump is leading President Biden by 6 points. 49 to 43, and then the independent candidates, Robert Kennedy getting 4%, and everybody else just sort of in single digits. But the other thing that was, you know, maybe not surprising is only 3% of voters are undecided at this point. I mean, it's the beginning of July, and only 97% of people are locked in already. And I think that's significant, Jay, because if you're President Trump and you've got a 6-point lead in Wisconsin and only 3% don't know how they're going to vote, even if all of the undecideds broke toward Biden, you're still going to win Wisconsin. So this is a very, very good poll. This is very, very good news for President Trump.
Well, it is a strong result for President Trump, and it makes me wonder if we can believe it. I mean, you've been with the WNC in Washington and been watching politics now for how long? We both
almost 20 years.
Yeah, we've been around forever. You and I doing this sort of thing. Can you believe your own findings here that Donald Trump's really leading by 6 points in Wisconsin? And if so, why? Because, I mean, this is a split state. And yet your poll is the third poll, I think, over the last week or so that shows Donald Trump with a 5 or 6 point lead in Wisconsin. At some point, you got to could actually be happening.
It's a scientific poll. It's statistically valid. There, like every poll, Jay, there is a margin of error. But I think it's important to point out that President Trump's lead in this poll, and it is a statewide poll, is outside of that margin of error. But, you know, I think we all need to take a step back and understand that this poll, like every poll, is taking a look at a snapshot in time. And we still have 3 months to go before the election happens. And as you know, Saturday taught us, there are events that none of us could even conceive of that can happen between now and November. So I think despite the fact that this is a very, very good poll for President Trump, if I was advising President Trump, you know, I would say keep your foot on the gas.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. This thing isn't over by any means.
And here's the other thing that I would suggest. This is right after the disastrous dementia debate. The poll is taken. You have Joe Biden down by 6 to Trump. But if you look at RFK Jr., he had, what, 4 or 5 in this poll?
Yes.
I mean, if you give those to Biden, it's a closer race. It could be that people are shifting over to RFK Jr., and that's creating this gap here. So, I mean, I think this is the third poll now that has shown about a 5 or 6% advantage here in a multi-candidate race for Donald Trump. You also found a slight GOP advantage in the congressional ballot question. I wonder how much that's been the case in the last 50 years of Wisconsin. Talk about what that might indicate.
Well, that's another important data point, Jay, because typically when you ask the question generically, will you vote for the Republican candidate for Congress or the Democrat candidate for Congress? In Wisconsin, the Democrat usually has a slight advantage over the Republican. And you're 100% correct here in our survey. The generic Republican is actually leading the generic Democrat by a few points. And I think that just evidences an attitudinal shift in this particular election cycle. And it reminds me more of what the 2010 electorate looked like, as opposed to, you know, what the electorate looked like in 2020, for example. Mm-hmm. And if I may, I think that the reason you're seeing that is that we also asked a lot of other sort of issue-based questions like, what do you think about inflation and what do you think about the border and what do you think about abortion and so forth? And what we found, no matter what question we were asking, is that independent voters were aligning themselves with the Republican voters' point of view by large margins as compared to the Democrats. And and that's why I think you're finding that people are generically supporting Republicans, because they're viewing the Republican position on things like inflation and the border and crime and so forth as being more in line with their views.
And this, again, does all sort of add up. But one reason your top line finding on the presidential race is also, you know, likely true is that 6 in 10 Wisconsin voters say the country's on the wrong track. The poll has Donald Trump up by 6 points in a five-way race. You're finding in the U.S. Senate race between Eric Hovde and Tammy Baldwin also mirrors a few recent polls. It's tied. Do you find that surprising?
I mean, that's probably the biggest surprise in this particular poll from my perspective. You know, we have seen a lot of polling that I think indicates a very, very tight race for U.S. Senate. But a lot of the polls that we had seen before we partnered with the American fuel and petrochemical manufacturers to do this one showed that it was about Hovde trailing by about the margin of error of the poll. So to see a poll where he's tied, and this is, I think, the second or third poll that we've seen, showing Hovde and Baldwin tied, I think that's gigantic.
Again, shows a very close race with only 3% of voters that you spoke to undecided. This is going to be a very close race for Senate, regardless of what might happen at the top of the ticket. That's at least what it suggests. By the way, listeners, we're talking with Scott Manley, who's the Executive Vice President of Government Relations for WMC, about a new poll that they just put out. So knowing Wisconsin business owners as you do, what do Wisconsin business owners want to see out of their U.S. senators and congressmen? You were talking about the Eric Hovde, Tammy Baldwin race. I mean, what are they hoping Tammy or Eric do for them if they're in D.C. claiming to be representing Wisconsin businesses? What's top of mind for these business owners this year?
Well, for a lot of them, Jay, it's just get government out of the way. You know, let the free market work. We have world-class manufacturers in this state and in this country that are being held back. They cannot release the full potential of their manufacturing ingenuity and the innovation that goes along with it, because government won't allow them to. So I think that's a big piece of it. I think they want to see a competitive tax climate where they can exist in a global economy and be competitive from that standpoint. But, you know, just dialing back these regulations. I mean, this poll, we asked a lot of questions about Biden's proposal to require about 70% of all new cars and trucks to be electric cars and trucks. Yeah. And, you know, Ford happens to have the most popular vehicle sold today. I think this is a really good example. The Ford F-150 is the top-selling vehicle in America. And right now, Ford, because thinking about the Biden's electric vehicle mandates, Ford is losing over $100,000 per truck.
Yeah. It's insane. It's insane.
Per truck. So if your number one product is a pickup truck and you have to make electric pickup trucks and you lose over $100,000 on each one, you're just not going to be in business very long.
Right.
So businesses just, you know, want government, get out of the way, let us interact with our consumers and deliver the best product to consumers for the lowest and best price, and, yeah. and that's what they want.
I had asked you specifically about what Wisconsin business owners want to see out of their government. This poll, I just remind people again, was just of likely voters. This was not specific to business owners. This is Wisconsinites, what do you think? And you did ask about a number of things, including electric cars or EV mandates. Your findings were what? 6 in 10 voters in Wisconsin oppose a government ban on gas cars?
Yeah. I mean, the voters want to be able to make their own decision on this. They don't want Joe Biden telling them, I'm going to force you into an electric vehicle. I mean, that they just, you know, isn't this odd, Jay? Because consumers actually want to have a choice in how they spend their own money instead of having the federal government in Washington, D.C., telling them how to live their life and how to spend their
it's
money.
Sort of interesting to me that only 1 in 5, less than 1, and it was about 1 in 5, 22% actually support such a ban. That number of around 20, 22, 24%, it always pops up. There's just this hard core of about 1 in 5 Americans who are really socialistic in nature. They're really willing to have government dictate everything for them, and the rest of us are pretty much leave us alone. But when you look at an issue like this, stay out of my life and don't tell me what car I can drive, how does it really affect how people vote?
Well, I think it significantly impacts how people vote, and by a super majority, by better than 2-1, voters say I'm less likely to vote for a candidate who's going to tell me what kind of car I have to drive. And who's going to take that choice away from me? And I think that is part of that attitudinal shift that we talked about as to why Republicans are doing better generically this cycle than Democrats are. And we're seeing this shift manifest itself in voting behaviors for key voter blocks. And I just want to talk about one of those, and that's this sort of gender gap of, you know, how do men versus women think about things politically? When we ask the head-to-head ballot question, Trump versus Biden versus Kennedy versus West, what we found demographically is that Trump is actually leading, and I know this is shocking, Trump is actually leading Biden by 1 point in our survey, and Trump is among women. And is leading by 13 points among men. You would expect Trump to be leading 13 points among men.
Right.
But you would expect Trump to be losing by probably 13 or 14 among women, and he's winning by 1.
At least.
And the reason why he's winning by 1 point among women right now instead of getting creamed like he did in 2020 with female voters is because female voters in this election cycle are much more focused on issues like crime and inflation and security than other issues, including social issues. And that, I think, is the biggest difference. If you want to get to the root of why, in this survey, Donald Trump is leading by 6 points and the Senate ballot between Hovde and Baldwin is tied, it's because women voters demographically there's been a realignment.
Yeah, we have women and independents. It sounds like women and independents in Wisconsin have really shifted significantly.
Actually, to that point, Jay, in this survey, Trump is leading by 13 points among independents, and only 5% of independents remain undecided. And so the question is, we've got 3 months to go. How durable is that lead among independents going to be? And if it proves durable between now and November, there's essentially no path for Biden.
Yeah.
I mean, that's probably the biggest challenge he has between now and November to get some of them back.
Here, and that's a pretty good way to wrap this up. So I would thank you for your time this morning.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Jay.
It's Scott Manley, the Executive Vice President of Government Relations at WMC. The results of this poll, I am sure, are going to have WMC more convinced than ever that one of their roles needs to be fighting for consumer choice and protecting our basic consumer freedoms. So you got a huge number, about 7 in 10 Wisconsinites saying they're against any sort of electric vehicle ban. and efforts to force consumer choice by government. It is 623 on WISN.